name is Tara Simmons, and I am also coming home from a prison sentence 4 years ago. I grew up in poverty, and every single person in my family has suffered with substance use disorder, and most of the people in my family have been incarcerated. I became a mom at 14 years old. I left home at 13, and somehow I was able to pull my life together and go on and graduate college at 21 and become a registered nurse. But you know, in my early childhood, I suffered a lot of different trauma, and I never sufficiently dealt with that. And so later on in my life, when my father passed away, I was going through a lot of different emotions, depression, and I ended up becoming an addict myself. And so I ended up going to prison for delivery of a small amount of drugs. And when I was released, you know, I mean, prison is already more traumatizing, but when I was released, I was able to keep my RN license because they saw that I had substance use disorder and that was treatable, but I couldn't find a job. Like Teresa said, you know, I actually got into interviews, and one of the jobs I applied for was working from home as a telephone nurse consultant, and I had actually done that before. You know, I don't have any access to drugs, I don't have any access to patients, and I got to an interview, and then I disclosed, you know, what I had gone through, and of course, they rescinded any hope for that position. And so I was working at Burger King with a bachelor's degree and an RN license, and I had so many legal barriers I was facing. You know, I had court debt I was imposed $6,100, but with the interest, I come out owing $7,600. I had a family law case. My home had been foreclosed on while I was in prison, and I was being evicted from it, and I had a variety of legal issues on top of the economic issues and the family reconciliation issues and just trying to get your life back together. And I was around, you know, so many other people experiencing these problems too. And I decided I was gonna go to law school and figure out how to change the system for myself and everybody else. And I didn't know that there was so many advocates like you already working on these issues. And it was really naive. I thought, I'm gonna just figure this out and I'm gonna fix it. And I thought it would be that easy. And I started law school in 2014, and I graduated in May. And when I graduated, you know, I graduated, you know, magna cum laude with the Dean's Medal, and like, you know, like all with all of these honors and recognitions, and a Skadden Fellowship, which some of you might know what that is. I was the first directly impacted person to get a Skadden Fellowship, also from my school. And then I go to take the bar exam, and they say, no, you can't do that. You have a criminal record. And so, you know, I started my fellowship about 2 months ago, and it's right now it's a fight to get admitted to the bar, honestly. But it's also doing the work I've been doing throughout my law school journey, and that is I developed a nonprofit called Civil Survival, and we are directly impacted people advocating for systemic policy change. So we work on a variety of issues, whether it's ban the box for employment, LFO reform, you know, recently in the city of Seattle, they banned the box for housing. And right now I am gearing up for the legislative session because I think it goes beyond the box.